If you want to access some of the devices in your home network while you're away from home, or if you want to host something like a game server or a website on your home network, you need to make some configuration changes to your router in order for that to happen. Specifically, I'm talking about implementing port forwarding. In this episode, I'm going to be explaining what port forwarding is, how it works, and when you should be implementing it. In order to understand port forwarding, we first need to understand the first word of that term, ports. When it comes to systems like your computer, ports are essentially channels, kind of like channels on a two-way radio. On a two-way radio, different channels are used for different communications, and the same is true for systems like your computer. Your computer uses a port to establish a communication with another device, and the fact that there are multiple ports that they can use. To be specific, there are 65,535 available ports. But to be specific, all of these ports can be used for different communications with different devices. This is how your devices, like your laptop, can have multiple communications with multiple devices happening at the same time. Now, some of these ports are designated for specific communications. For example, port 443 is used for HTTPS. In other words, that's the channel that's used to reach websites securely in an encrypted manner. There are other ports that are designated for many other specific services, but a lot of these ports are open and available to be used by your system for communication to other devices. Now that we have a good understanding of ports, let's talk about port forwarding. As I mentioned in the introduction, port forwarding allows devices that are outside of your home network to access devices that are in your home network. So to give a little context here, the reason that we need port forwarding is because the devices on the public internet have public IP addresses, and the devices in your home network have private IP addresses. By default, public IP addresses cannot communicate directly with private IP addresses. This is due to a technology called network address translation. If you'd like to better understand this, I previously made a video breaking down what NAT is and how it works, so you might want to check that out before moving forward. So with this inability of devices with public IP addresses to communicate directly with devices that have private IP addresses, this is what you need port forwarding for. Port forwarding will allow these devices on the public internet to reach out to the specific devices in your home network that you designate for port forwarding. You might be thinking that this sounds like extra work to set up port forwarding, but let's talk about what the normal behavior is with a home network. You normally don't want devices on the public internet being able to access the devices in your home network, just for cybersecurity concerns alone. The last thing you want is hackers poking around at all the devices in your home network, because then it's more likely that your devices will be hacked or compromised. Now, port forwarding is just used in the unique cases when you need to work around that and you want to make something on your home network publicly accessible. So what are the cases where you need to get around the security protection that network address translation provides and you need to make something on your home network available on the public internet? Well, here are a few examples. Number one, if you have a web server in your home and you're hosting a website that you want people on the internet to be able to access, great example for port forwarding. Also, if you're hosting something like a game server, say you have a Minecraft game server, you want people to be able to access and use it, you need to implement port forwarding. The same thing if you have a security camera or security system at home, you want to be able to access and view that feed when you're away from home. Again, you need port forwarding for that. And also too, if you want to remotely access your laptop, say your laptop is in your home network, you want to be able to remote into it and make changes or access something on that system, then you need port forwarding for that as well. In order to understand the specifics of how port forwarding works, let's take a look at an example. Okay, here's a simplified example of a home network. On the left-hand side here, you have the devices in your home network. And for this example, let's say that this right here is a server and we want to host Minecraft games on it. So in order to make this publicly accessible by our friends here in these two houses that are remotely located, what we need to do, as I mentioned previously, is we need to implement port forwarding. Another important thing before we move forward of this diagram is here you have your router in the center here. your router has a private IP address and a public IP address, so that way it serves as the middleman for communication between the public internet and the devices in your home network. So let's say we don't have port forwarding enabled, and our friend here in this home tries to access our Minecraft game server. What happens is they send a request to the public IP address of our router. Again, remembering that public IP addresses can only communicate with public IP addresses, and private IP addresses can only communicate with private IP addresses as a result of NAT or network address translation. So this request comes into our router saying, I want to access the Minecraft server on your home network. The problem with this is because in our NAT table, we don't have any port forwarding rules in place, so our router doesn't know what to do with this traffic. So what does it do? It throws it in the trash. But getting into port forwarding, the way around this is to implement a port forwarding rule. So when implementing port forwarding, if we want to make a port forwarding rule, the most important thing we need to understand is what that default port or channel is for the Minecraft game server. So this default port is 25565. So we need to make a port forwarding rule for this port. So what does this look like? Basically what it says is we make a rule for our router that says anytime you receive a request on the router's public IP address, as in you're getting traffic from the public internet to your router, and that request is for port 25565, using the private IP address of the router, we want you to forward that traffic to the 192.168.02 device at 25565 at that port. Okay, so let's walk through what this looks like. Your friend sends a request to your router's public IP address saying, I want to access this port 25565, which is the Minecraft server port. And because we have this port forwarding rule, our router says, oh, okay, I know what to do with this traffic. For any requests that I get for this 25565 port, I'm going to forward it along to this device at this port. So it basically takes this traffic, it uses the private IP address of your router, and it forwards the traffic on to 192.168.0.2 at port 25565. So in short, what's basically happening is if traffic comes to a specific port on our router, it forwards it to the device that we specify, which is our Minecraft server. Geez, I wonder how they came up with the term port forwarding. Well, that's exactly what it does. So upon receiving this request, our Minecraft server says, okay, it returns the request through your router on its private IP address, which transfers it over to the public IP address of the router, and returns the requested information to your friend over the public internet. And once the port forwarding rule is in place, any device on the public internet can access your Minecraft server by sending a request to the Minecraft server port 25565. So if you have another friend at a different public IP address, they send the request to your router for port 25565. And again, because that one port forwarding rule is in place, your router knows what to do with the traffic. It forwards the request to your Minecraft server. Your Minecraft server returns the request and it finds its way back to your friend at the other public IP address. That's the basic overview of how port forwarding works. And although we used a Minecraft server in this example, the same process and procedure applies whether you're accessing your laptop away from your home, hosting a website on a web server in your home network, or if you have a security camera that you want to access remotely. All of the process will remain the same regardless of the device you're setting it up for. I'd also love to see in the comments section if you have port forwarding enabled, and if so, what are you using it for? As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network from Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.